Good evening and welcome to Thai PBS World. And right now, Khun Thep Chai Yong is joining me live from home. Khun Thep Chai, today
good evening, Khun Thep Chai. Yes.
We see tougher measure from Prime Minister Prayut Chan Osha. Curfew will be effective from tomorrow night.
This is something that has long been anticipated. In fact, the Prime Minister himself has been hinting at tougher measures. And of course, curfew was always mentioned as one of the possibilities. So it did not come as a total surprise to most people. Now, when we talk to a number of people on the street, including market or street vendors, they were quite aware of things that were coming. And they said they understand the need for the curfew to be imposed, because they all also want to see a quick end to this pandemic, right? But of course, Kunatha, there is a question as to the hour, about the hours of the curfew. Why only between 10 p.m. and 4 a.m. the next day? Because these are not normal hours for most people, right? These are hours in which people with special jobs and people who are involved in some late night business that are most affected. One of the answers is that despite the restrictions imposed under the National Emergency Decree, there are still a lot of people in many provinces who still go out at night after midnight in the wee hours of the day to have drinks, to have parties, to have fun. So this is something that the authorities are not happy about. And that's why the Prime Minister Prayut decided that tough measures like curfew needed to be implemented in order to put a curb on the spreading of the deadly virus.
That's right, and the order would like to attain in controlling the number of infections, because as long as the number of new infection each day is more than 100 cases, it's still the cause of alarming for Thai country, for Thai society as a whole, especially when Prime Minister take a look at the number, he is not quite happy with the rising of the curve of the total number of infection. That must be part of the reason that the announcement of curfew is announced today.
Yeah, that's right. And another focus of the government attempts to curb the virus is on Thais and foreigners coming from overseas. Because a lot of people, including Thais and foreign travelers who arrived in Thailand in recent weeks, many of them were tested positive for coronavirus. And many of them have been in contact with a lot of local people. And in the process, they become spreaders of the virus. And that's why the Prime Minister today made it clear that he wants to see, in fact, if he can have his way, he wants to see a total halt to the arrivals of people from overseas. But of course, that's not possible. So there will be few exceptions. But the objective is to limit or to maximize the number of people arriving in Thailand from overseas. And of course, we have been reading reports about how many Thais who returned from overseas and then tested positive and then became themselves spreaders of the virus. So the government intends to minimize the number of people traveling from overseas.
And in the Thai PBS World tonight at about 7 p.m., we talk to Dr. Panithan Wattanayakorn, who is the chairman of PM Security Committee Advisory. When Khun Thep Chai asked him about the reason, the last straw, what's the reason that the PM has decided to announce curfew today, so listen to what he has to say.
A week has passed since the emergency decree has been applied. I think you see a lot of cases of violation, hundreds of violations in various areas, especially people still traveling to get together at night. People still have parties in certain areas. Although majority of the people are now staying at home, they are very much fully cooperated with the government, but the minority of some of these pockets, especially in areas like Bangkok and surrounding provinces, must be controlled more. I think this is one of the purposes. Another purpose is, of course, to allow life to function normally. I think you cannot disrupt the whole society. You cannot break the chains of the production. There will be more crisis if you do that. So in the next days ahead, we will see flexibility on the ground. We will see some confusion, of course, at the checkpoints, as who can get out, who cannot get out. But I hope that in the next few days, things will be much better.
It's quite a dilemma, Khun Thep Chai, because on the one hand, the government would like to maintain normalcy, but under the situation of pandemic, it's quite difficult to maintain normalcy in the society.
I think it's a question of communication. I think the government certainly have to do a lot of work in trying to make people understand the need for these tough measures. Because I think the future of the country is on the line. Everybody knows that if this thing is not put under control soon, then we'll go the way of some European countries, which now have become centers or a center of the epicenter of the outbreak.
Not complete, but you get the idea that the country is now moving into a tighter control at the borders, at the border provinces, incoming
trips are
now curtailed, including to those Thai who want to return. Now they are facing more tougher measures, as you indicated that there are some of the infected cases bring back from abroad. So you see in the next week or so, you may see more extended, tougher measures in different areas, as you see in certain countries. Certain countries, the curfew are longer than in Thailand. Prohibitions of the public transportation took place in different countries, including Vietnam and other countries. But for Thailand, as Prime Minister indicated just a few minutes ago, the situation is still under control, but very difficult and very tight. A maneuver that we are now doing at a very critical juncture. If you can get this cooperation going on in the next week or so, you can see stepping down in certain areas. People cannot live like this, Khun Thep Chai, for years or for months. This is unusual. We are now moving into Songkran festival.
That's
we are moving into school opening festival or opening sessions. We are moving into now postpone the conscription of the military. We are moving into different areas that for now you cannot do. And that will increase tensions in the household, in the society. So you need to give a take and be more flexible.
To flatten the curve of infection is clear aim of the government right now, Khun Thep Chai, because they would like to reduce the number of infection as much as we can in Thailand.
เข้าและออกเวรทำงานหรือการเดินทางมาและไปท่าอากาศยาน
people and to make sure that they're not violating the decree at the moment for the time being the police is leading the operations on the ground with the healthcare workers this is serious I think the second order announced a few minutes ago is very seriousBut in the beginning, you can see more flexibilities. People may need to go out and to get letters of certificate to be verified tomorrow, the day after tomorrow. You can see confusions maybe as who can come out, who cannot come out. But within a few days, I think we need to bring the situation at night under control and less people will be going out at night. And this is serious. If you violate that, you face tough penalties.
So from tomorrow night, it means after 10 o'clock at midnight, people are not allowed to go out of home, Khun Thep Chai.
So we need to learn to adapt to a new way of life after dark now.
So that's the announcement by Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha with the uplifting of the measure, tougher measure on curfew, which will be effective from tomorrow night, and it will be in place until further notice. And you can follow us on Thai PBS World tonight to keep you stay informed about COVID-19 on our program, which is on air on Thai PBS World at 7 p.m. from Monday to Friday. And that's all from Thai PBS World tonight. Khun Thep Chai Yong and me, that's Thai PBS World tonight for English news.